Hello friends, and welcome back to another video from my YouTube channel, that is Vipin Sharma Biology Tutorials. And in this video we are going to talk about the sex determination, which is quite important topic. Kyunki is important topic se kafi sare questions bante hain in pre-medical entrance examination as well as in board, that how the sex is determined in case of different kind of organisms. Okay, humans mein kaise sex ki determination ki jati hai, how the sex is determined in case of drosophila, in case of birds, in case of different kind of insects. So it truly forms a very important question. The system of sex determination is asked, the homogametic or heterogametic groups are asked, and the genotype as well as, you know, the different kind of chromosomal arrangement in case of males and females are asked in examination. So this is the symbol of male, if you don't know. So this is the symbol for male, and this is the symbol of female. So we are representing male and female for different kind of organisms. Okay, so what is the basics of sex determination? Kaise hame pata laga tha ki sex ko determine kiya ja sakta hai on the basis of chromosomes? We know very well that there are 23 pair of chromosomes in case of human beings. Out of 23 pair, that is 46 chromosome, 44 are autosomes and 2 are sex chromosomes. And these two sex chromosomes are XX in case of female and XY in case of male. This is quite general thing and we know very well about that. Ki females mein XX hota hai, okay, sex chromosomes, and male mein XY hota hai. These are known as allosomes, and other 44 are known as autosomes. So these sex chromosomes are somehow responsible for the determination of sex in an individual. This concept was given by Hanking. Hanking ne experiment kiye the in some insects. So in that insect, he studied about the spermatogenesis or the gametogenesis process. And we know very well about spermatogenesis, right? After some stages of division, they will form sperms. So in that sperm, he have talked about the chromosomes. So in insects, he found that the male is having XO. It simply means that it is having only one X body. Okay, so 50% are X body. Kyunki yahan par do hone chahiye the sex chromosome. So yahan par ek X hai. So 1 by 2 is 50%, that is 0.5. So 50% of the sperms are getting X body and 50% are not getting the X body. Kyunki do sex chromosome hone chahiye the jisme 50% is the X body, that is X, and the remaining one is O, that is the X body is absent. So Hanking ne naam diya tha X body. He gave this term X body for this chromosome, which is now called as X chromosome. But at that time, at the time of Hanking, he have called it X body. So that X body is somehow responsible for the determination of sex. This is called by Hanking. So the experiment of Hanking were further revised and are, you know, again repeated by different kind of scientists, and they call them X chromosome. X chromosome, which is quite important for the determination of sex. Now we know very well about X chromosome, Y chromosome, autosomes, allosomes. Ab hamare concept thode clear hai, because after that there are a lot of experiments on chromosomes, genes, introns, exons. So abhi hamare concepts thode bahut clear hai is mamle mein. So at the time of Hanking, it was called as X body. Now it is called as X chromosome. So let's talk about the very simple case. We will start from the very simple case, which is quite relatable, because this is humans. Okay, the number one is human. In human beings, the male is having XY chromosomes and the female is having XX chromosomes. So now a question arises, that which of the following is going to be responsible or mainly responsible for the determination of sex? Okay, if a male and a female are mating, then which individual is going to be, you know, much responsible for the मेल और फीमेल नेचर ऑफ बेबी. सो लेट्स टॉक अबाउट इट कि कैसे पता लगता है कि बेबी कैसा होगा. सो इफ यू विल टॉक अबाउट अ फीमेल, सो दिस इज एक्स एक्स एंड इट विल क्रॉस विद एक्स वाई दैट इज मेल. ओके, सो एक्स एक्स विल फॉर्म गैमेट जो कि सारे एक्स टाइप के होंगे. इट कैन ऑब्वियसली फॉर्म टू गैमेट्स जो कि होंगे एक्स एंड एक्स अगेन. सो देर इज नो डिफरेंस, दोनों के दोनों एक्स ही बनेंगे. सो इट इज नॉट रेस्पॉन्सिबल बिकॉज इट इज गिविंग ओनली सिंगल टाइप ऑफ गैमेट. बट इन केस ऑफ एक्स वाई देर इज एन एक्स गैमेट, देर इज एन वाई गैमेट. दिस इज समहाउ रेस्पॉन्सिबल बिकॉज लेट्स टॉक अबाउट अ सिंगल एक्स. व्हेन दिस एक्स कंबाइन विद द एक्स ऑफ मेल इट विल फॉर्म अ फीमेल. ओके, विच इज हैविंग इक्वल कंट्रीब्यूशन. बट व्हेन दिस एक्स ऑफ फीमेल combines with the Y of male, it will form a male. But this Y chromosomes come from male only. So if male will give X chromosome, to female ban jayega. If male will give Y chromosome, to male ban jayega. That is the basic concept. So in all the cases, the heterogametic parent will decide the fate of next generation. There are two terms, heterogametic and homogametic. Heterogametic and homogametic. Hetero means different. So in XY, both are different. There is one X, there is one Y. In homogametic, both the gametes are same. For example, in XX, there are two gametes formed. One is X, another one is also X. So female is homogametic, so it will not decide the fate of generation. But heterogametic means it will form two different kind of gametes. It can decide the fate of next generation majorly. This is majorly responsible for the generation, for the next generation's fate. कि वो male होगा या female होगा ये decide करने का जो ज़्यादा contribution है, that is to heterogametic parent. So in case of human beings, there are two kind of parents, male and female. The male is heterogametic, that is XY, and the female is XX. So the male will decide the fate. Okay, now the second organism is Drosophila. Okay, second organism is Drosophila, a fly, a very small fly, a kind of insect. So the kind of sex determination in it is also XY XX system. This is known as system. We can call it XY XX system of sex determination in humans. Similarly, there is also same kind of sex determination system in Drosophila. So Drosophila ko bhi hum kya bolenge? XY XX system. In this, the female is homogametic and the male is heterogametic again. So the male will decide the fate of next generation. This is similar, exactly similar to the human beings. So Drosophila and human beings have XY XX system of sex determination. Now let's talk about some birds. Okay, this is quite important and this is asked several times in the examination. This is very important example. So in birds, the system of sex determination is ZZ and ZW. Now what is unique in this case? ZZ is male, that is homogametic, and ZW is heterogametic. Okay, it means that in this case female will decide the fate of next generation. This is quite interesting to note. So yahan par ZZ chromosome honge. The name of chromosome is a little bit different. Yahan par XY the, yahan par Z and W hai. So the ZZ is for male, which is homogametic in this case, which will not decide the fate. ZW is heterogametic, that is female, which will decide the fate. This is in case of birds. Okay, birds ke case mein sex determination kuch aise kiya jata. After that, a very important example, that is insects. Commonly grasshopper. Grasshopper is a very common insect. I hope you know about it very well. So grasshoppers mein kya hota hai? There is XO and XX. XO means no chromosome is present over here. So the XO is heterogametic. It can give X as well as O. And XX is homogametic. So in this case also, the male is heterogametic, it will decide the fate of next generation. So, सारी की सारी चीजें कैसे होती हैं? In case of humans, it is XY and XX. XY, that is male, will decide the fate. In drosophila, similar case as compared to human beings. Similar, exactly similar. XY and XX, XY male will decide the fate of next generation. In birds, the case is quite different. There is ZZ and ZW type of sex determination. ZZ is homogametic male and ZW is heterogametic female, which will decide the fate. In case of grasshopper, there is XO and XX system, where XO is male, which will decide the fate because it is heterogametic. These are the different kind of systems of sex determination in different individuals. Okay, so in humans and drosophila, it is quite similar. In birds, it is interesting. So this is quite important from examination point of view, as well as that of insect. Okay, so these are quite important examples. You have to note down the hanging, the meaning of X body, homogametic and heterogametic, as well as the type of sex determination, XY, XX, XY, XX, ZZ, ZW, XO and XX type of sex determination. So this is quite important. इसको बार बार revise कीजिएगा, क्योंकि ये चीजें काफी बार दिमाग से निकल जाती हैं. I hope आपको ये concept समझ में आया होगा. अगर आपको concept समझ में आया, then do hit like button. And if you are watching my video for the very first time and you found it beneficial, तो अपने दोस्तों को मेरे चैनल के बारे में बताइए और मेरी वीडियोस उनके साथ शेयर कीजिए. Thank you so much and stay tuned.